Let's look at parametric and non-parametric tests. We're going to be looking at different types of tests. So these are different types of parametric tests, and these over here are different types of non-parametric tests. And I know this chart looks confusing, but I'm going to go over it, and I hope that you guys will have a better understanding at the end of this video. So first things first, let's look at the parametric. When we look at this column over here, it says that the typical data set that we normally see is ratio or interval. Right now, just think numbers. If I throw numbers at you, so if I ask you what's your height and you answer to me in numbers, so you might say you're 5'1", 5'5", 6 foot, those are all numbers. Those are all quantitative. If you give me quantitative data, the type of tests that you will be using to make your conclusion would be a parametric test. If I ask you what's your age, and some of you guys will say 18, some of you will say 20, some of you will say 25, 30, you're answering me in numbers. Anytime you answer me in numbers, anytime you give me numbers as your answers, that when the data is in numbers, the type of test that a researcher uses would be a parametric test. So it would be one of these tests. Let's look at this one here, ordinal or nominal. So let's just quickly review what they mean. I'm gonna bring this over here. So anytime we have categories, the type of data we would have is nominal or ordinal. Nominal is basically if I want to find out whether you're male or female. So I go around the class and I tally up how many males are in the class. So let's say we have 2 males in the class and how many females. And let's say we have 30 females in the class, for example. That's nominal because you're categorizing yourself as either male or female. If I want to know how many of you guys are smoking or how many of you guys are smokers in this class, if you're a smoker, and let's say there's 2 of you, there's 2 smokers in the class, and let's say 30 non-smokers in the class. Okay, so anytime I ask you a question where you're supposed to answer in words or circle a word like male or female, smoker, non-smoker, I could ask you another question as to what type of pets do you have, dogs, cats, fish, right? Those are all nominal data because it's you're answering to me in words. The data that we're getting are words, qualitative, which also means words. Ordinal is when we have to order categories, when we have to rank categories. So the R for rank or ORD for ordering. So for example, if I ask you what type of clients do you most see, do you mostly see clients that are that have mild perio? Are they mostly clients with moderate perio, or are they clients with severe perio? That's ordinal data because you're asked you're asked to rank, right? Mild, moderate, and severe. If I ask you how much pain are you in minimal pain, moderate pain, or severe pain? That is ordinal. It's ordinal because when you look at the categories are ranked, the categories are put in order. When you look at nominal, we do not put the categories in order. We're just stating male, female. We're just stating smoker, non-smoker. We're not saying that one is better than the other. Whereas in the ordinal, here we are saying that if you're in minimal pain, that's better than if you're in severe or unbearable pain. If I asked you what degree of difficulty your client is your client a DD1, a DD2, a DD3, or a DD4, that's also ordinal because you're ordering the categories. Someone who has a DD4 client will go through a lot more challenges in debriding that client than perhaps someone who is a DD1. So I'm gonna pull this aside. I'm gonna explain this using examples. So let's look at one example over here. I'm gonna pull this up over here. And we'll look at this example here. Let's say we have 2 groups that we want to research, that we want to study. One group has a manual toothbrush, so a regular toothbrush. The other group has an electric toothbrush, so maybe Sonicare or Oral-B toothbrush. And I tell everyone in the group to go with this toothbrush and brush with this toothbrush for 1 week. After 1 week, I want them to come back. And when they come back, I'm going to test their plaque-free score. What type of test would I be using? So the first question we want to ask is the data set quantitative or qualitative? And to do that, let's bring this back down here. Is it numbers or is it words? So plaque-free score, bring this down here. Plaque-free score, is that answered in numbers or is that, you know, tested in words? Numbers is the correct answer because we could have 70% plaque-free score. We could have 20% plaque-free score, right? So the answers are in numbers. So just based on that, it's a parametric test. So it's one of these answers. One of these tests are what will be applied to analyze the data here. The second question we have to ask is how many groups are there? And there's two groups. When you have two groups and it's an independent measure basically means you're only testing them once. So in this case, I gave the group A the manual toothbrush. I gave group B the electric toothbrush. I told them to come 1 week later and I'm going to test their plaque-free score. And that's it. I'm not asking them to come back again in a month and again in another month. No, I'm asking them to come back 1 week later and that's it. My research is done. After that 1 week, I get their plaque-free score and I'm done. I'm concluding my results. I'm concluding my study. When you have independent measure, when you're only asking them to come once to get tested, and you have two groups, the type of test is a t-test. And that's what I would type in over here. So the type of test that I would use over here is a t-test. Because it's a t-test, because it's a parametric, so there's numbers, because plaque-free score is number. And I have two groups, group A and group B, and they're independent measures, which means I'm only testing them once. I'm only testing them in 1 week, not repeating the study again after that week. Let's look at example two. So example two, bring this up a little bit, is we have three groups. Group A, manual toothbrush. Group B, electric toothbrush. Group C, no toothbrush. And I asked all these people in the group to go brush for 1 week, come back in 1 week, and I want to test all of their plaque-free score. So again, plaque-free score is considered numbers, right? It's in numbers. It's a parametric test. So it's a parametric test. How many groups do I have here? I have three groups. So when I have more than two groups, when I have three groups and it's an independent measure, which means that I'm only testing them once. So they're going to come back in 1 week and I'm going to test in 1 week what their results are, what their plaque-free score results are. The type of test that I would be doing here is ANOVA. Let me type that down here. So the type of test that I would be doing over here is ANOVA, right? The one-way independent measures ANOVA test. Okay, so independent measures ANOVA test. Why? Because I have three groups, one, two, three, right? Three groups, more than two groups. And it's an independent measure. I'm only testing them once. I'm only asking them to come once to me, which would be 1 week later. And that's it. I'm not asking them to come again and again and again. No, just next week they are to come to me and I will test their plaque-free score.